Today we're looking at songs that stole from classical music. Here we have Sergei Rachmaninoff, Piano Concerto No. 2 in C minor, Opus 18. That was flawless pronunciation from me there. Oh, that's pretty. Sick. Like I'm watching a Disney movie right now.
An old one.
Here's Eric Carmen, All By Myself.
When I was young, I never needed anyone.
Oh, this is awesome. I love this song.
And making love was just for fun.
That's crazy. I thought that this pop song was really original, but obviously not. It just copied something I wasn't aware of. Which is probably true with most of the things you like that seem unique. They just sampled or were inspired by something you never heard about.
Living alone, I think of all the friends I've known.
That's sick vocals too.
But when I dial the telephone,
this is awesome. Who sings this in the more famous version? Surely it's not Eric Carmen. Yeah, Celine Dion. She is one of the best singers of all time though, so it makes sense. Here we have Franz Schubert, Ave Maria. That's beautiful. How high is that? It's a high D, I guess. Here we have Beyonce's Ave Maria. Wait. So she's just covering it? Wait, I thought we were talking about stolen songs. Oh, tune that guitar, Beyonce. What are you doing? I'm sure it's you playing.
She was lost in so many different ways, out in the darkness with no
I'm obviously not a big traditionalist when it comes to music, but there's something a little bit blasphemous if she's gonna go from this super poppy kind of generic verse into the Ave Maria melody.
Ave Maria.
Oh, she did. That is pretty tasteless, I have to say. That's not the coolest thing Beyoncé's ever done, to be honest. Here we have Johann Pachelbel, Canon in D. I think I know which song stole from this, but let's see. Uh-huh. Very classic. He's a pretty, pretty man. Look at those eyebrows. He tweezed them. Now, this is a very beautiful song. Staring into those dreamy eyes. And here we have Oasis's Don't Look Back in Anger. What? Oh, yeah. It's the same chord structure. How could they steal from the man with the dreamy eyes? I can't believe it, guys. Inexcusable.
Here's to the ones that we got.
Oh, yeah.
Cheers to the wish.
This is
here,
both the chords and the melody, pretty much.
Memories of everything.
Just think about it. We talked about this in one of these videos. So this one was not new to me. Maybe it was to you. Yeah, very well done. You learned something. Fun fact, it's actually legal to steal from a lot of classical music because of the copyright duration of composed music. The composer's life plus 70 years. That's why I'm gonna go for eternal life so I can steal Shape of You once Ed Sheeran has been dead for 70 years and earn bank. By the way, welcome back to another daily video. My name's Joe from Rumi Official, and this video was inspired by Two Set Violin and David Bennett, two incredible music channels that I have collabed with in the past. Here's a meme from the subreddit, the true music term. It's out of tune. It's off key.
It's a little bit pitchy.
It's the dog. That's what I'm talking about. Get the merch, guys. It's a little bit pitchy. So you can bully your friends who are a little bit pitchy and make them never do music again. It's the right thing to do. Link in the description to the merch. Here we have Vox Ariosa from Cantata BMW. No, not really. BWV 156. Okay. He also has beautiful eyes. Just look dreamy. So dark.
Thank you.
And here we have Hey Jude. Huh. Some of the melodies are stolen. What? I gotta listen to the melodies again then, because I did not memorize that. Oh yeah, that is Hey Jude. But yeah, it doesn't go on like Hey Jude. It's just a phrase. I'm always like, was this really stolen? Wait, but that little thing that went up there in the melody also kind of sounded like Hey Jude. So here we have Hey Jude.
Hey Jude, don't make it bad.
And that's where the similarities end.
Take a sad song and make it better.
Side note, Ally's incredible.
Remember to let her into your heart. Then you can start to make it better.
She's scrolling through the lyrics as she's singing. I think so. Here we got Box. I think you say Bach like that. I'm not gonna check it. Here we got Back.
I want my baby back, baby back.
Fugue number 24 in B minor, BMW 869. I gotta stop saying BMW. BWV, okay. Wow, that is pretty advanced, or like, that doesn't sound like you could translate that into pop music very easily. Also, just haunting eyes. What a beautiful man. Baby's got baby back ribs, man. That's what I'm talking about. And apparently that's in Bad Romance. Anyone hearing Bad Romance here? The only thing I see is that Lady Gaga is a very attractive woman and Bach was a very attractive man. That's the only thing. The intro is stolen, but speeded up 3.5 times. What? Oh yeah, that's just a straight up copy, yeah. Oh, and this super dumb sponsorship well of the speaker. There is something blasphemous about it, I have to say. It's just a blatant commercialism. I'm sure classical music was also just commercialism as well. They were all hired by freaking monarchs and stuff. And like, make me a song for my dog's birthday. And they would do it, right? Okay, here we have Pavarotti, Vesti la Ghiba. Pavarotti? He didn't write this, surely. I never noticed how he sings like that. He sings with like kind of widened lower jaw. Great tone. So dramatic. And here we have Queen's It's a Hard Life. I didn't pick up on that, to be honest. I gotta check that again. Now I can hear it. Oh, I miss Queen. I guess the modern equivalent of Queen kind of is Lil Nas X now when it comes to the theatrics and everything in the music videos. Have you guys seen Montero, the music video? You can say what you want about it, but like, dang, that is some of the best freaking visuals I've ever seen in a music video. What? Was that Living for That by Lil Pitchy? What a nostalgic song. I'm gonna go stream that wherever you can listen to music, on Apple Music, on Spotify, wherever, because it's everywhere. And you should too. Link in the description. You got Gabriel Fauré, Pavane in F sharp minor, OP 50. I know we've been talking about a lot of dreamy classical musicians and composers. Not one of them. What's he doing with his mustache? Come on, man. Ugh. I gotta stop looking at that. Ugh. Mm. And here we got Lil Mix's Lil Me, okay. They sampled the song and the chords are stolen. Think about it, guys, they're stolen. It's not illegal, but you can still steal things. It's like when I steal from myself this water bottle. Haha. I am on top of it today, guys. Oh yeah. That's pretty. For some reason, this feels less blasphemous to me. It just works with the emotion that was there and doesn't try to make it like... I don't know what to say about the ones that I didn't like. It's like, take it into this awkward space. This is good though. I like this. I want to focus on the good things. So yeah, here we got Ezio Basso, Symphony Number 2, Under the Trees, 4th movement. Ah, that's fun. This sounds easy to sample for a dramatic pop song. Loads of 16th notes. And here we have David Guetta's Dangerous featuring Sam Martin that copied it. Oh, straight up. For some reason, I kind of like it. I think it's pretty. And yeah, we'll see where they go with this though.
You take me down, spin me around. You got me running all the lights.
I don't hate it. I don't know why this works better for me. I guess they are still preserving what made the original good. Like they didn't switch it up like crazy, speed it up 500 times or put it into some super generic context. This song still seems pretty emotional and nice. Oh, okay, that's synth. That takes it a little bit more towards the cringy direction. Here we got Eric Satie, Gnossien Number 1. I'm totally butchering all these names, I know. I'm trying my best, okay? Is this the Donnie Darko soundtrack? They copied this? That's so pretty. No, it isn't. It's G-Eazy X Carnage. And she want the guala guala. And she like the guala guala. That's cool. She want the guala guala. And she like the guala. I like the music video. Guala guala. Guala guala. Guala guala. That music video is great. But yeah, that was an alright sample. I don't hate it. Here we got Martini Plaisir de Amour. That sounds like Can't Help Falling in Love with You. Is that it? Yes, it is! I got it, finally.
Wise men say, only fools rush in.
This music video, what's going on?
But I can.
Is he proposing to the old lady or the young lady?
Falling in love.
Or not to anyone. What is she holding? It feels like a movie where the actors didn't get any instructions and was just like, okay, so I'm gonna stand here, I'm gonna look at him, and that's all the direction you get. It's so awkward, like if I would look at the camera for like 10 seconds. That's enough of that. Here we got Gioacchino Rossini, The Barber of Seville. Another maybe not as dreamy man. Pretty wide. Getting some wide Putin vibes here. That is hilarious. Okay. Was this really stolen? Oh yeah. Why you let sky? Very loosely copied. This is not really a theft, from what I can hear anyway. We got Beethoven Sonata Number 8 in C minor, opening 13, or opus 13. I don't know what OP stands for. Overpowered 13. Finally, another dreamy classical composer. Look at that. Look at his stern face. I want him to scold me. Where's the female classical composers? I want a really crushing classical composer, come on. Here we got Billy Joel, This Night. Huh. The chorus melody is mostly stolen, okay. This night, it's mine. It's only you and I. Okay, I want to hear that again then. I think I want to hear if that is in the Billy Joel one. It's only you and Yeah. He went for another high note, maybe because it was out of his range or he didn't want to go into falsetto or something. But overall, yeah, the structure definitely the same. And here we got Claude Debussy, Clair de Lune. I guess Lune. It's like Luna, like moon. Oh, that's so pretty. I gotta start listening more to classical music. I'm relaxing so hard. But when things are that slow, it's so hard to take in the melodies, though. I just know it's nice, but I couldn't sing that back to anyone. Okay, so here we have Janelle Monáe's Say You'll Go, and the piano part is stolen a little bit. Very pretty. Didn't strike me as stolen in a bad way, to be honest, but it was definitely inspired. Here we got Johann Sebastian Bach. Baby got Bach.
I want my baby back, baby back, baby back, baby back.
Prelude number one in C major. This one even I know. Okay, and here Zayn has copied it totally and blew 100%. He should go to jail for this. How could you do this to my man back?
Baby back.
Bach. Yeah, there we got it. In the synth. I mean, this is just straight up copied. Oh, they have it with a do-do-do-do vocal. A little bit of cringe on that, I gotta say. Ooh, I thought it was a synth at first, and I was like, yeah, that's kind of cool. And then I started hearing the do-do-do-do-do-do-do. How could you do that, Zayn? Are you insane? We got Ludwig van Beethoven, Bagatelle, Tagliatelle, number 25 in A minor, Fear Elise. This is a classic. My mom played this for me when I was a kid. I'm not knowledgeable with classical music, I have to say.
I'm such a pop guy.
Here we got Nas's I Can. I know I can be what I wanna be. This is kinda cool. I do where I wanna be. I know I can be what I wanna be. Be what I wanna be. If I work hard at it, if I work hard at it, I'll be where I wanna be. I mean, that was a good sample. I enjoyed that a lot. All jokes aside, I think being inspired by classical music is a great thing. Unless you absolutely ruin them, like some of these did, let's be real. But overall, it was a good experience to hear these. Okay, guys, you here for more music commentary videos? You here for music VS videos? Here's another meme from the subreddit. Joel, my husband is using your meme against me. When you're trying to watch a video, but you keep having to take off your headphones because someone is talking to you. Oh, I need that on my wall too. Just point to it. What an alpha move. I love it.